5, 4, 3, 2.
It's Thursday, December 13th. We hope that everyone's having a great week.
You're watching DBTV Thunderflash. I'm Tatum.
And I'm Ava. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Now let's take a look at your daily bits of information for the last time in 2018.
Softball players, there will be open fields today from 3:30 to 5:15 p.m. on the varsity softball fields. Anyone is welcome, so bring your glove and bat.
Sophomores and juniors, there will be an Event Expo open house on Saturday, January 26th from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Come discover how you can start training for your career in high school.
On December 20th, help us thank the staff at Desert Vista. Sign up to donate a gift card, donate baked goods, or donate money to help put on luncheons throughout the year. We can't do it without you. Thanks in advance for your support. It means so much.
Finals are coming up and grades are close to being finalized. So take a look at this video all about grades.
All right, DBTV. Today, you're here to see how your peers feel about getting graded. Do you think you're being graded fairly?
No, I'm not. The current system of grading is more based on your ability to do homework than it is like the testing knowledge. So I don't think I'm being graded fairly.
I do definitely think I'm being graded fairly. I feel like for the amount of work I do, I am receiving it very fairly.
I feel like I'm being graded fairly most of the time. I mean, my grades have been very consistent and, you know, decent, so I mean, yeah, being graded very fairly.
If there was anything that you could change about the way you're being graded, what would you change?
I think it's fair enough already. I don't think you should change much.
Focus more on classwork than it is homework, or like being one-on-one with the teacher to like have them test what you know, have them grade you based on what they can tell you know.
How do you think about the way you're being graded? While you think about that, we'll bring you back to DBTV.
That was some good information. Today and tomorrow are the last days to purchase a Winter Wondergram from the Sophomore Student Council. They are being sold during both lunches for $2 and come with a candy cane and handwritten note. They'll be sent out on Monday to your teacher or friend.
Now here's a look at the problems created by leaving trash on our campus, created by our beginning class.
We went around asking students if they've noticed a trash problem that's been at Desert Vista lately.
Yes, every table is a mess. We don't do it at home, so you guys should not be doing it at school. Did it, you high school, you should be proud of it instead of trashing.
Sure. Yeah, there has been trash.
We do develop trash during the lunch hours.
Yeah, I have. It's kind of crazy.
Next, we questioned them on why they think there's been such a problem.
Those are lazy.
I think just it's a lack of awareness of like the fact that someone has to clean up after you every time you leave garbage around.
I think students don't respect their school. Yeah.
Lastly, we asked the students what they think could be done about the trash problem.
They should pick up their own trash, you know, because we are responsible for our well-being, the way we behave.
They need to learn how to pick up after themselves.
I think just start trying to pay attention more, and like when they walk around with trash cans at lunch, put it in the trash, or just try not to throw pieces all over. Little things like that.
This has been John Tobias reporting for DBTV News.
Thanks for that information. Try to keep our campus as clean as possible and help out our cafeteria staff.
Now let's head straight into sports.
I'm Dean with sports, let's get into it. Last Wednesday, the varsity wrestling team improved its dual record to 7-0 with wins over Shadow Ridge, 69-6, and Queen Creek, 66-15. They followed this up with a tournament championship at the Coyote Open. This was the first time the team has won this event after finishing second the last 2 years. The team had six wrestlers in the finals and came away with four champions, as well as two other top four placers. Two of the champions were also named outstanding wrestlers for the event. Here's a list of the people that medaled. The team also traveled to Red Mountain for a multiple with Highland and Red Mountain on Wednesday, December 12th. Way to go, wrestling. Here's a look at what else is on sports calendar. That's all for sports. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks for that sports update. We hope that you enjoyed watching our show.
Follow us on Instagram at DB Thundervision for more behind the scenes stuff. And you can also, if you miss us over break, you can check out any of our newscasts on YouTube.
Have a fantastic winter break and a great holiday season.
And we'll see you back here in 2019. Woo woo!
Yeah.